Everybody, welcome back to another episode. I have Pranjan and Satyaji today, so the four founders of Dainty Mitra. Thank you very, very much for being here. It's a pleasure, pleasure to have you both of you. Thank you very, very much. Thank you.
Hi, Lakshit.
Hi, Lakshit.
Yes, yes. So before we begin, why don't you introduce both of, you know, if you both can you introduce yourself to us and what you do and all about your backgrounds and how you began. How did you meet and how did you start the startup? Yeah, please, over to you.
Hi, I'm Dr. Pranjal, and I'm a dentist and a professor in dental college and hospital.
Hi, this is Satyajit Pradhan, an awarded tech entrepreneur with a decade of experience in startups, and we are the co-founders of Dentamitra. And coming to the what about our experience, I have been in the industry since quite a long time. I have been a part of startups like Carwale, Car Dekho, and I was recently featured in Forbes India as Doyen in Tech, and I had received other accolades like CEO of the Year, 40 Under 40, and Rising Entrepreneur of the Year. And 2 years ago, I was featured in the cover of Inside Success as a 10 Dynamic Business Achiever to Watch in 2018. Dr. Pranjan and me are both childhood friends, and he's an awarded dentist, like he said. And he's also a professor in dental colleges and hospitals. We are friends from right from standard one, where we are studying. And after a decade, after a long gap, although we both were studying in Bangalore, after a long gap of 20 to 25 years.
We need to
discuss about our this startup Dentamitra. And that's how the two close friends met after a long time to build something valuable for the society.
Wow, beautiful, beautiful. So, Pranjan, why don't you take us through how it all started and what was the whole story behind and how things happened? Yeah.
Yes, Doc. Why don't you share your interesting story? I think you're the one who got that idea to me.
Yeah. Sure. Thank you, Lakshit. So there is a very interesting story why Dentamitra came up. So during one of the OPD days, a patient came from very far off, around 70 kilometers, and he had traveled 3 to 4 hours, and also he had waited 45 minutes in the queue for getting the OPD done, and he panicked that he had some oral cancer. And when I examined, it was just a simple stains, fluoride stains, which we usually have due to excess of fluoride in the water. And when I examined him, I saw that he was not able to maintain in oral hygiene. Then I inquired, what is the problem? Don't brush properly or what? Well, sir, I'm not maintaining my oral hygiene. I don't brush properly twice a day, whatever the recommendations are. And also, when I inquired him, have you ever visited a dentist previously? Then he told us, sir, I have never visited a dentist for the past 2 to 3 years. So seeing the plight of the patient, he had traveled so much and he took the day off from work. So later on, when I came back from work, just a thought of in my mind that why can't there be some technology that can at that spot determine what oral problem we have and bring the whole oral care to our homes. And if it would have been happened, that then a lot of resources and time of that person would have been saved. So that idea kept on in my mind. Then obviously the COVID situation happened, clinics were closed, and my patients were calling up, sir, how we are going to get treated. So they're also coming up with a lot of dental problems. So I took this further up with my childhood buddy Satyajit, that can there be a solution so that we can bring the whole dentistry at people's doorstep so that they don't have to go anywhere. And that's how Dentamitra was born. And that is how Dentamitra is oral healthcare anytime, anywhere.
Great.
Over to you, Satyajit, for anything.
Right, Doc. So that's where I think, Doc has said his the dentometer is basically his idea, being a dentist, and that was where he wanted to change something in the oral healthcare. And in India, where we have, a population of huge population, and oral healthcare is not the one where I think people are skeptical about oral healthcare. Compared to the US or the European countries, but oral care is one of the most important part when it comes to the healthcare. And that's where he brought up to me that he wants to revolutionize the oral healthcare, like other essential factors. Like when in India, the essential commodities or essential needs like food or clothes or your even the house search, your house, you can book your house, car, everything, and even the medicines can be delivered at your doorstep or can be booked through an app. Why not digitalize the oral healthcare, which is the most important part? There are several challenges in the oral healthcare. So he discussed this, that that he needs my support, he needs my tech, my expertise in tech and product, and my business expertise. And we both, the medical and the tech, we both need to collaborate and revolutionize this. So that's where I also really like that. Yes, as a startup, our main intention is to change the society, bring a change in the society, prove something valuable, build something valuable to the society. And that's where it immediately clicked on my mind. Yes, that we need to do it. Then when the COVID struck in, the demand for the oral healthcare increased again. And the plight was for the oral treatments were increased. And we thought that this is the right time where you need to come in and serve the society. And I think during the pandemic, we released our product within 3 months of hard work. We released our product, and within the pandemic, we released, that is July last year, 2020. And we served more than 3,500 patients till date. And that is within pandemic. So I think that's where, Dentamitra, is the idea that that have been up, is running in our minds, like yes, this is what we wanted to build currently.
Okay, so the whole idea was to bring the dentistry in into your home, make it easy and convenient for people, right? And did this idea come to both of you in the phase of lockdown and all of that?
See, like I said, before lockdown, he had discussed the challenges of the oral healthcare. And then the COVID added a factor to it. We thought of building it, but we were not sure when to start it. But the COVID gave us the reason now. This is the right time to start, because the demand, when the closure of clinics due to the lockdowns and the pandemic, that the demand of the oral treatment when it rose. So that's where we thought that we need to work really over within this quick nick of time and release our product.
Okay. So and what are the challenges in the whole, starting into something very, very new, and where it's kind of something which people, it's kind of thing which people do take, but not everybody does into a scenario of India. It's not everybody who takes care of their oral health. I have never been to an dentist, I think just once since I have been 17, I've only been once to a dentist, right? So I just want to know what were the problems? What were you thinking when you wanted to start this startup? Yeah.
See, like I said, in India, I'm not sure about if people know about it. US and European countries, they're the most, when it comes to oral healthcare, they take it as a very important thing that they need to do. And that's why the dental market is one of the biggest market in US and Europe. But when it comes to India, there are certain challenges that's where the dental care has a setback. First is the dental treatments is a high cost treatments, and is the fear of the dentist. Third is the missing of oral hygiene habits. Like, although you know that you need to brush twice a day, but you don't take it seriously unless the tooth pain really occurs to you. So that's where these kind of mindsets were prevailing. But I think this was happening before COVID. Before COVID, even healthcare was, people were skeptical about healthcare. But when the COVID struck in, they realized that healthcare is one of the most important things they need to take care. Even every factors in the health. So that's where the mindset of people have started change. And now you see there are more, I mean, every day you'll see one of the new healthcare startup is coming up.
Great. Yeah, I totally agree. I've seen that, a lot of news coming about startups which are trying to, you know, help and people, all of that. Yeah. So moving forward, Pranjan, I would like to come to you with the next question. What were your major lessons getting into entrepreneurship? As Satyajit said, that he has always already been in the startup space for a decade and more. What has been your major learnings, and what did you learn, and what are your learnings from it? Yeah.
Yeah, basically, entrepreneurship, they say, is very glory, but actually it is very, very challenging.
Yeah.
And when you people take the word entrepreneur, is very like fascinating word, but it's really very challenging. And first of all, my background was not from business. I am basically a doctor. So that also was challenge from us. But I had my childhood buddy Satyajit with me. But definitely there are challenges, and when you start something revolutionized in the oral care setup, like nobody has done before. So that is also a very big challenge, because we have to discuss the ideas, then implementation part, and a lot of things has to come up when you are revolutionized, because there is no one who has done it before. Yeah. And also there are a lot of things like what are the funds, these things. Funds and our team. Luckily, I had Satyajit with me, so we collaborated. We are since friends, so it has a very easy on my part.
And coming to one thing, and when it becomes extremely challenged for a startup or an idea to become successful, when you are doing it for the first time and no one else have tried. It's a lot of testings, lot of examination, lot of challenges every day you need to face, because you are changing, you're trying to change the habit of the people. And the acceptance of the people you need to work on that. So that those are the challenges where and the ideas were being executed for the first time. I think those are the critical part where, and I think thanks to my experience to the startup, and also to his Dr. Pranjan Smitra's dentistry experience, we jotted down those the challenges that might come in, and we created the roadmap of the solutions, how we need to go step by step, and what would be our milestones for the next 2 years. And that's where we are overcoming each of these things. And that's where we have been doing good now.
Okay. And for you, Satyajit, you know, being in a tech space and then coming into something as healthcare and some oral care, what have you been your major learnings being into this setup of a startup?
Well, when my expertise is tech, product and business, and I'm still doing that. But yes, the industry is different. And being into a business, and I have to, and being into serial business, and serial entrepreneur, I have to learn different kinds of business at different phases of life, or else life becomes very monotonous. If I work on one industry for a whole lifetime, for me, it's a very little bit of monotonous. But, and I also like to work on industries where nothing has been done. And that's where I readily accepted the idea of Dr. Pranjan, and thought like, hey, let's work on it. Or else I would have said, okay, I will just help you out. You go and build it.
Mm-hmm.
But
mm-hmm.
My intention is I love to take up challenges. I love to let's do it. So that's where, my expertise and experience are still the same. I'm still working on growing of the business, working on the product, working on the technology. My things remain the same. Only the industry is different.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So just last question to both of you is what are What would be your advices to anybody who wants to start a startup in any kind of a setup? Let it be from the experience of Satyajit, who has been into a tech space and then coming to the oral, and from your experience, Pranjan, from being into a space where you teach and where you were an employee, and then now starting a startup and being an entrepreneur and trying to do something different, which you have done your whole life in being different than that. So what are your main learnings, and what would be your advices to anybody who wishes to become an entrepreneur?
Doc, why don't you share your tips first?
Sure. Yeah, when we are as an employee and when we're working somewhere, actually, we don't get to think of something, the idea. Like we have something in our mind, but we think of it that we will take it forward, whether to take it or forward or not. But when you are in internship, you are just like a free bird. You have a lot of ideas, then you focus on what to implement. Mm-hmm. And how to get in, and you think on the broader aspect.
Mm-hmm.
When you're an employee, you just take 9 to 5 job. Mm-hmm. That's after five, then is it. But when you're an entrepreneur, constantly your mind is thinking. Yeah, even if in a sleep, you get off some of the ideas. And believe me, I get up some dreams. So what
don't sleep, I think, yeah, you ping me every day at 3 o'clock and in the night, and hey, can you just log in at 3 a.m. in the night? So I think that's where actually he's testing this for the first time. And that's actually a quality of a startup entrepreneur, when he thinks of his ideas every day, every night, every hour. And even I have gone through this phase, and I'm still that keeps me awake every night, that what's going to be do tomorrow, what's going to do next. Like, so that's how it, I mean, that's how an entrepreneur or a should be like. Or else, if something is letting you sleep, then you are not an entrepreneur. You are a startup entrepreneur when that is not letting you sleep.
Yeah.
And when if you are an entrepreneur and wants to taste the success, you need to. I believe in 3 P's. That is patience, persistence, and your patience, persistence, and I missed one more thing, but yes.
Perseverance,
right.
Perseverance, yeah. I follow it, actually.
Exactly. I'm sorry, I missed it, but yes. So these 3 P's are the key to any success for a startup entrepreneur. You need to be persistent. You need to think business like you are watering a mango tree, you know, and you have to give water every 2 years, 3 years. You should not think that, okay, hey, it is not giving me a fruit. Hey, this is a waste of time. You should not think on that. You should do your duty well. You should do your duty on time. You should, it should not let, and take care of things well. I think after right amount, after right period of time, it will give you right results.
Totally. Yes. So, yeah, thank you very much. Go ahead.
I want to add, always, Satyajit used to share with me. Usually people think that money is always the byproduct. We should not, when we are starting up, we should not think about money. We should all work on our idea. That is the most important. Money is always the byproduct. And we should think out of the box, something innovative, which nobody has done. And we should also have the courage. And one more thing which we should always make the things impossible. Like it is a challenge. Nobody could do it. So why not we try it? We give it. Make the impossible. Then only you can work. Yeah.
Totally.
That's what I get from Satyajit.
Great. So thank you very, very much for being here with the few, Satyajit and Pranjan. It was a pleasure to have you both. And I think people who are watching this would surely learn a lot from your journeys, from your work, and from your experiences. Thank you very, very much for being here. It was a pleasure to have you.
Yeah,
thank you so much.
Yep. Thank you so much for having us.
My pleasure. Thank you. Thanks to you.